Hello. Since I started service a year ago as your president at Queen's College, you have been so welcoming. Beginning with the video of students greeting me in more than a dozen languages, reflecting the diversity not only of our campus, but of the world's borough. Now I'd like to take a moment to express appreciation, to thank all of you for what you have done to see us through a most challenging year. We want to share this video as a preview of the, frankly speaking, special message that you'll find in your email inbox. Over the past 12 months, I've met so many of you, students, alumni, faculty, and staff, on different virtual platforms. Now I'm looking forward to meeting you again in person, for real, soon and safely, on our beautiful campus. We're building our future. Over the past year, we engaged in a strategic planning process. Now that together we're emerging from the pandemic, we have a guide for the next 5 years developed with all of you. Our strategic planning process, and that process is as important as the product, involved 6 dozen different members on working groups and hundreds of attendees at town halls, looking at the curriculum, at diversity, equity, and inclusion, at faculty scholarship and creativity, at fiscal sustainability, and at student success and student life. You should be proud of what you accomplished. If you haven't had an opportunity to come to a town hall or learn more about the strategic plan, watch for the published version in the fall. You'll be impressed at where we're headed. Among the biggest developments are the new arts school and business school. These will offer our students the training that they demand and deserve, preparing them for the competitive marketplace. We already have all the pieces for a first-rate art school and for a top-notch business school. We just have to put it together. Watch for the details in the Queen's College magazine coming out this fall. It's the cover story. We made it through the challenge. I'd like to highlight just a few of the events. You'll find more details in Frankly Speaking. We're so grateful to the Queen's College Foundation, a nonprofit established for the exclusive purpose of supporting the school and our students. They allocated on an emergency basis an unprecedented $3 million, almost all of which went directly to students, including through the Knights Table Food Pantry that distributed grocery gift cards and bags of food to fill people's pantries at sites throughout the borough. At our 97th commencement ceremony, we honored Congressman Adriano Espiat, one of our own, an alumnus who became the first Dreamer ever elected to the House of Representatives. He received the President's Medal, the highest administrative honor that I'm permitted to confer. Also, we awarded an honorary degree to Miriam Rafilovich, a former faculty member here who is a leading scholar and teacher in the sciences, training the next generation to follow in her footsteps, dedicated to ensuring that her academic discipline is open to people of all backgrounds. Most importantly, we conferred degrees on more than 5,000 students. Despite the pandemic, our students are doing terrifically in the classroom and beyond. Both the men's and women's tennis teams won the championship in the East Coast Conference yet again, serving the greater good. We know that Queen's College is a civic institution, an anchor institution that plays a valuable role within the community, far and wide. As we continue to rebuild after the pandemic, there is so much for us to do, collectively and individually, to play our part. We've been doing that all along. Back in April, we helped to bring the pandemic to a close with our pop-up vaccination site. More than 1,000 individuals received the Johnson & Johnson single-shot vaccine right on campus, yours truly included. That's just part of what we do. We're also a site for elections, for early voting, time and again, and we look forward to continuing that role. The civil society that is so important, that's the foundation of our diverse democracy, it depends on institutions such as Queens College. Thank you once again. Thank you especially to the essential workers who day in, day out have been coming in for the past year, making sure that everything is ready for our return. Thank you to the students for your resilience. Thank you to the faculty for your adaptation. Thank you to all of our stakeholders. I know there is much more work for us to do. We begin now in earnest. I can't wait. We'll see you soon.